Hey everyone, April here. Welcome to my channel where we talk all things Power Platform and Microsoft 365. Earlier this month in May 2021, three new Dataverse for Teams Power Apps templates were released. So of course I have to break them all down and go over them for you, and I'm going to start with the Profile Plus template in this video. This Dataverse for Teams template is great for getting to know the colleagues in your team. You can see where they work from, their contact information, what projects they're working on, their expertise, their goals, and their interests. And you can even use it to be able to post open positions and explore those also. I'll break down how it all works, what it looks like, and how to install it right after this. Now to install this template is going to be a little bit different than some of the other Dataverse for Teams templates that we've looked at. Profile Plus isn't going to show up here in the Teams App Store or here inside of the Power Apps application inside of Teams as a selectable template. We're going to need to go to GitHub to download the code and import that into Teams. So to do that, you can go to aka.ms/teams-profile-plus. And that will take you here to this repo. It has some documentation that will walk you through how to install it. And to get to the actual files that are stored here, you'll go over to the right and you'll see a section for releases, and you'll want to get the latest release. In this case, this was 13 days ago. So we can open this in a new tab and we'll see two zip files in here. So one of the things they've did is provide us two different ways that we can import this Profile Plus solution. One way is it's going to give us a managed solution. We can take this solution, which is this Profile Plus Teams custom app, take that managed solution and upload that into the Teams App Store. And that will go through an automated setup process so that we can have that installed quickly. A benefit of using the managed solution, in addition to the fact that it's a quicker setup process, is that when new versions of the app template here for the Profile Plus are released, we can easily just import that using the same process and have that push out the updates. However, one of the things with managed solutions is it locks down what we can actually change as far as a solution. So we might not be able to change the underlying table structures or individual components that make up the solution. So if we want complete control over the solution and be able to edit, say, the underlying table, security, and individual components, then we also have the option here to import what's called an unmanaged solution. And that is this Profile Plus Dataverse solution zip file that we have. If you download and use that one, this will give you the ability to import the unmanaged solution either into Dataverse or Teams or full-fledged Dataverse. Now, it will be more of a manual setup process that you have to go through, but you will have that access to all of the underlying data to be able to make any changes that you want. For simplicity's sake, I'm going to show installing the managed solution and how that process works. So to do that, we'll just click on this Teams custom app zip file, and that will start a download process for us automatically. And now we're going to go into Teams, select the Apps tab from the left rail, and then select the Upload a Custom App option in the bottom left-hand corner. Depending on what permissions you have with inside of Teams, you'll either see one of two options, Upload for me and my team, or Upload for my org. So if you're a Teams admin, you'll see that Upload for my org option, and you could select that if you want, so that anyone in Teams will be able to use this Profile Plus app. So we'll find that zip file that we just downloaded, click Open, and that will install the Profile Plus Dataverse for Teams app here in the App Store. Now, if we want to use it, all we have to do is click on that and select the Add to a Team option. Just select the team that you want to deploy this to. So I'll choose this HR team and select Set up a tab. In this pop-up, just choose whether you want to post to the team channel that you have installed this new application. Then click Save, and this will run through its automated setup process. So give it a few minutes, let it run through the setup process, and it will alert you when it's done. It shouldn't take longer than 5 minutes tops. Once it's done installing, it'll prompt you with this message to authenticate into the different connectors that the template uses. We can see that it's leveraging Office 365 users, groups, and stream. So click Allow here, and that will open up the application. And now right now we have this with inside of a tab in our HR general channel. So we get this message that pops up, just giving you a little bit of detail about what this particular template does. So just click Continue to move past that. And I believe this should only show up the first time that you load the application. And just to make sure this doesn't show up again, you can click the Don't Show This Again, and then got it. And that shouldn't pop up the next time that you open up the app. Now, right now, even though I have several people in my company here in this tenant, you notice that only one profile is showing. So this is the first thing that I want to point out of how this particular template functions. when you add this template into a particular team, it's going to get the members and the owners and visitors and all of that with inside of the team. And that's what it's going to show in this Profile Plus app. It's only going to show the members of the team that you have this installed in. So let's take a look at this HR team and see who the members are. So if I click on the three dots next to it and go to Manage Team, we'll see that I'm the only one in there, which kind of makes this whole Profile Plus app not so much fun. So let's add some more people from my company to the team so that we can see how this works. So I'm going to add a member. So I'll search for Jamie, and we'll add Morgan, and we'll add Alex in there too. Now that we have a few more members of this team, let's go back to our general tab and back to our Profile Plus app. Now you see when I load up the application, it's taking those three new team members that I've added and surfacing up their profile information in the cards here. So how this works, if we go into someone's profile in here, say take my profile, it's going to show you some details about that person. Now right now my profile is pretty bare, so I can select the edit button and I can add in some additional details about myself so that my colleagues can explore that. So I can give an intro. And you'll see where the stream connector comes in. We can actually upload an intro video about ourselves and put that link here in this field. So that will support stream or a YouTube video link. So I'll actually go out to my YouTube and I'll just copy this Power Platform Rewind video and I'll use that in my profile. So I'll paste that in there. And we can also paste in our LinkedIn profile so people can see more about us from that. And then if we scroll down, it also gives us the ability to put in any projects we're working on and what our expertise are in. And this to me is one of the biggest benefits and the coolest features of the Profile Plus template. Being able to find colleagues and people in the team that are working on the same projects you are or that have the expertise that you might need to know about. So if you're stuck with a Power Apps question, this would be really helpful to have an app like this where you can find people that have that listed as an expertise and maybe reach out to them for help. Right now, we don't have any projects or skills listed, so nothing shows in the dropdown. But we can use this text box here and add in new projects and skills. So let me add in a quick project here. I'll click Add, and this will populate some data in a table in the back end. And now that will make this project available as a selection if I click that dropdown. So I'll select the Timesheet Power App Template project. And let me add in a few expertise here. So I'll add Power Apps, of course, as an expertise. We'll add Power Automate. And how about Power Virtual Agents, Power BI, and let's throw SharePoint in the mix. Oh, and of course, Teams. We can't forget Teams. All right, so we have several listed there. Now if we click that dropdown, I can choose as many of these as I'd like. So I can choose Power Apps, Power Automate, Virtual Agents, and let's do Teams and SharePoint. So you can see I have five items selected there. Now I can switch over to the Goals tab. This is just a free form text box where I can list any goals that I may have. So maybe I'll put my goal is to increase Power Platform adoption across all of Fourth Coffee Company. Now let's go over to the Interest tab, and this is the exact same thing, just a free form text box where I can put in things that I'm interested in. So I'll just do all things Power Platform again. And finally, you'll notice we have this Open Positions tab. This is another really cool feature of the Profile Plus template. So not only can we use it to explore our colleagues on here and maybe who reports to whom and see their interests and their projects that they're working on and their specialties and all of that, but we can also list different positions that we might have so that we can explore and see what other openings we have within the company. I'll come back to this. Let's save my profile so far so that we can see how that will look on the data card. So I'm going to save everything that I put in. And there we go. So you see the data card. Now I have my intro that, hello, I love all things Power Platform and Microsoft 365. There's my intro video that I uploaded. And then there is a link to my LinkedIn profile that if I click that, it will open that up in a new tab. The information here on the left, you see where I have my name and the profile picture and email address and works from and lives in. This information we can't customize within the Dataverse for Teams app here itself because that is being pulled in directly from your Active Directory profile. So if for some reason, like in my case, I don't have that filled out in my AD profile, that's not going to surface up here because it's using that Office 365 users connector to pull in that data. So to update that information that shows here, I would need to go into my Office 365 account if I wanted to update that for myself, click on my name in the upper right-hand corner, and go to My Office Profile. And then we'll see an option here to update profile. So this is where I can go to change my profile picture, for example. So I can click on the picture icon there, upload a new photo. There we go, click apply. So I just updated my picture there, and that should update this app here in a minute after some jobs run behind the scenes. But how do we update this works from in Libsyn? Well, to do that, if we have the necessary access, we can go to the admin portion of Office 365 and jump here into the user section. So we can find the user that we want to update the information for, like myself, click on my name. And then here in the contact information section, I can click manage my contact information. So in the office, I believe that's what they're using to pull in the works from information here. So in my case, I can actually say home. And then lives in, that's the street address and city and all that. So I can just put Tulsa OK, and that should populate that. So I'm going to save my changes. And again, when you do this, it will take a little bit for some jobs and everything to run behind the scenes before that is populated in the template. But with the magic of video editing, I've just refreshed my app, and you can see there is my profile picture now. There is my works from home, and then lives in Tulsa, Oklahoma. So that's how you make sure everyone's data is populated in their profiles in the template to make it really usable. So on my profile here, I can go to my goals, I can see that information I filled out, and interest. Let's go back to that edit tab and let's explore how the job postings aspect works. So if I have an open position on my team, I can go to the open positions tab and click add an open position. This gives me a very simple form where I can put in the job title, a description, and a link to maybe the career site or wherever that particular job is stored. So I can put a job title for a power platform advocate, and I'll just put in a generic URL here for now and click save. And now you see how this changes how my profile looks here. I see I have a new section that says open positions with the one. And then below my profile, I can see this little card that is populated after that, letting everyone know that's looking at my profile that I posted an open position today. If I click on that, it'll pop open a panel where it will show me the information like the job description. And then this is that hyperlink where I can go and open up the link that you put in there for the hyperlink for the job description information and how to apply. Now, if we go back to the home screen, in addition to the filter and being able to search for a team member, we have this filter icon next to it. And this is where we can actually filter people by their expertise and projects they're working on. So if I wanted to find someone to help me with the Power Automate issue, I can select Power Automate from the dropdown, click apply, and that will filter the list to show me everyone that's marked that as one of their expertise. Another cool feature is if we click on someone else, say maybe Morgan here, we have these quick contact buttons below to either start a chat with Morgan, call Morgan, or even schedule a meeting. So if I click the schedule a meeting button, for example, that's going to open up a new tab within Teams and take me right to the dialogue where I can schedule a meeting. And same thing with the chat and the call. It would open up a Teams tab and start either a call or a chat with Morgan. Another cool feature is if someone's profile isn't filled out, like Morgan's here, for example, we can request an update, which is just basically opening up a chat in Teams with the person with some information pre-populated, asking them to update their profile. Also, if we want to connect with multiple people in our team, we have this option at the upper right to select people to connect with. And that will make these cards here clickable and selectable. So we can click the checkbox next to several of these, like Alex and Morgan. And that will give me the ability to start a group chat with those people or schedule a meeting with both of those people. Another thing this template can do is show some hierarchy. So it can tell you how many people, for example, I have reporting to me or who my boss is. We obviously need that data to be populated in the user's profile for that to work. Right now, I don't have that filled out, but to show you how you could do that, I'll go back to that user section and I'll select Alex here and I'll add me as Alex manager. So I'll save that and then I'll select Jamie also and I'll add myself as her manager too. Now, if we refresh the app, you see on my profile card here, we have a new label that says I have two reports. So if I select myself, we'll see the organizational structure listed. So there's myself, and then those are the two direct reports that I have. So that's all that I had for you today. Hopefully this has been a great overview of the Profile Plus template and got you excited about it and wanting to install it. If you do install it and use it, let me know what you think. And as always, if you found this helpful, please give it a like, a subscribe, and I'll catch you in the next video.